Welcome back. In today's video, I'll be showing you how to fix headphones louder or quieter on one side on your PC or laptop. I'll be showing you within Windows 11, but the methods will work very similar in Windows 10. Let's get into them. The first thing I'd recommend doing is unplugging and then reconnecting your headphones. If they are wired, make sure they are connected all the way into the port, and you could also try a different port on your PC. For example, there may be another port on the back. Within Windows, we'll start by checking the volume levels for both the left and right side to make sure these are level. In Windows 11, open the Settings app, then choose System from the left, then Sound, and then scroll down and click on More Sound Settings. In Windows 10, right-click on the volume icon in the taskbar and choose Sounds. Both versions of Windows should now have the same window open, and in the Playback tab, look for your headphones on the list. First, click on it once, and choose Set Default if you can. Next, double-click on your headphones and head to the Levels tab. In here, click on Balance, and then ensure that both levels are equal. Once they are, click on OK and apply. Next, head to the Enhancements tab if you have this option, and you could try disabling all enhancements with the checkbox. After this, you'll need to click on Apply before testing your headphones. In the Advanced tab, you could test each of the quality format options in case one of these works. Finally, if you have the Spatial Sound tab, click on this and make sure that this is set to off and test it out. You could try with this on as well if having it off didn't work. Click on OK twice to close these windows and check your headphones now. There is a chance that the issue is caused by your headphones themselves, so if you can, it would be a good idea to test your headphones on another device, such as a different PC or laptop, to see if they work properly there. If they don't work there either, then unfortunately it's likely that the headphones will need to be repaired due to physical damage or a loose connection. We're now going to try updating drivers, re-enabling, and then reinstalling the device. To do this, search for and open the Device Manager. Within here, expand the section called Audio Inputs and Outputs and look for your headphones. Right-click on your headphones and choose Update Driver, then choose the Automatic option and allow Windows to search for driver updates. If there weren't any, we can now try re-enabling the device. To do this, right-click on it again, and this time choose Disable Device, then choose Yes. Wait a few seconds, then right-click on it and choose Enable Device. Test your headphones now. If this didn't work, we could try reinstalling the device. Right-click on it once again and choose Uninstall Device and then Uninstall. Now go to where it says Action at the top and select Scan for Hardware Changes. Try your device again now and you may need to unplug and reconnect the device if they don't work after disabling or uninstalling. Next, we can try running the Audio Troubleshooter. Search for Troubleshoot in the search bar and open the link called Troubleshoot Settings. Find the Audio Troubleshooter either on this page or after clicking on Other Troubleshooters, and click on Run next to it. You might then be asked questions about your sound device. Follow these steps and see if there's any recommendations to help fix the problem. It's worth restarting your PC if you haven't already. You could try this now or at the end of the video. Next, think back to when the issue started appearing. There is a chance that a software change or hardware change caused the problem. This could be some new audio software or a new component. If you are certain that one of these changes caused the problem, then you could revert them or research how this will have affected your device and what you can do to work around it. Unfortunately, those are all of the methods I have. As always, I'll keep the description updated with any new solutions I find, and if any of you find a fix in the future, then it would be great if you could return to the video and post it in the comments to help others. Click the card on screen now to watch a video of mine showing you 10 easy ways to speed up your Windows PC. If you have any questions, then let me know in the comments below, and if you did find today's video helpful, remember to leave a like and feel free to subscribe for more tips in the future. Be sure to stick around to see some of my other videos that you might be interested in. Thanks so much for watching, and I will see you in another video.